So don't forget, company income tax is for limited liability companies. Company income tax is for limited liability companies, and education tax is also for limited liability companies. So what happens is, at the end of every financial year, you're expected to prepare your accounts, that's audited financial statement, put in all your figures, all the details of your company, then you're going to calculate your profit margin. Then from your profit margin, you compute your company's income tax. Government will not ask you to pay tax on what you have not earned. Government will only ask for taxation based on what you have received. It is only when you fail to comply that government will now use the hammer on you, which will not be good for your business. So I noticed that a lot of small business owners do not track what comes in. And there is this issue of mixing personal money with business money. I think you must find a way to separate your business money from personal money. It is absolutely wrong for you to pay money that does not belong to your business into your company's account. When you put money in the account, the money has to be for the company. It's either a loan given to you, and if you're getting a loan, the loan has to be backed up by documentary evidences. Otherwise, by the time the tax authority requests for your records, you have to pay tax on money that you have not generated because you ask people to pay into the account. So all these things must be structured well. If you're a business owner, pay business money to the business account, then at the end of the month, pay yourself your own salary. You need to fix a salary for yourself. That's discipline. So pay yourself the salary, then you move the money from whatever is your salary will be moved from your business account to your personal account, and you spend directly from the personal account. Don't spend money directly for yourself from the business account. It takes discipline to do this. So when the tax authority comes to review your record, then the money they will see in your business account will be your business money. So business will pay his own tax on his own, and you will pay your tax on your own from your own salary. So from the salary you move it to your personal account, you pay personal income tax on this, then the business will pay corporate tax on the business. This is no double taxation. It's a bit, it takes discipline to achieve this. Somebody will say, how much am I even making? Start from day one. You don't grow big to put controls in place. You need to put controls in place so that you can grow big. It's very easy for you to comply. Very easy for you to comply. Rather than fail, then you now have to start begging people, or you have to start to make attempt to bribe the tax officials, which is also a crime on its own. Trying to bribe the taxation officials is a crime on its own. Of course, there are a lot of reliefs that government has given people. If your income falls below a certain, certain level, you are not expected to pay, especially for the first 4 years of your operation. Government expects that you need some time to stabilize. So first 4 years of operation, you are not expected to pay tax if you are not making any profit. But if you're making profit from your business, all businesses are not the same. There are some businesses that will start generating profit right from the beginning of their operations. But there are some that will not generate profit until maybe 5th year or 6th year. So for the first 4 years, you are exempted. And there are also some provisions in the law which is called pioneer status. If your company falls within the sector that is recognized for pioneer status, then your company will be giving tax holiday for the first 3 years of operation. And the law also provides that this can be extended on application for another 2 years, making 5 years. It's not for all companies, but you must apply for this and find out if you'll be qualified to benefit from this. So first thing after registration with Corporate Affairs Commission, get to the State Board of Internal Revenue and get yourself registered for taxation as an individual or as a company. You can find the Oyo State Internal Revenue, the office within the sectoral complex at Agodi, Ibadan.